So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to another session of PIB 247. In today's session, guys, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And remember, guys, these sessions are only for the current affairs of ESI. For the static part, you have to cover other things also. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for updated information regarding the sessions and also regarding the courses. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, which organization or association has agreed to STI-led, STI what? STI stands for Science, Technology and Innovation-led Innovation Cooperation Action Plan that was proposed by India. So first thing is, this plan was proposed by India. Okay, you have to remember this, that this plan was proposed by India. And the name of the plan is what? STI-led Innovation Cooperation Action Plan. Okay, so the question is, which organization or association has agreed to accept this? Okay, so let's talk about this news. So remember, all BRICS countries, jitni bhi BRICS countries hain, they have agreed to accept this India's proposed plan. And what is the plan? STI-led BRICS Innovation Cooperation Action Plan starting from 2021 up to the year 2024. Also remember that this plan was proposed by India during the recently held 12th meeting of BRICS S&T Steering Committee. Jo 12th meeting hui thi BRICS Science and Technology Steering Committee, usme इस प्लान को प्रपोज किया था इंडिया ने. नाउ व्हाट वाज़ द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस प्लान? इस प्लान का ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या था और इस प्लान को क्यों एक्सेप्ट किया गया है, क्या रीजंस हैं? लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दैट. सो दिस प्लान वाज़ प्रपोज्ड टू फैसिलिटेट द शेयरिंग ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ ईच अदर रिगार्डिंग द इनोवेशन. इनोवेशन से रिलेटेड सभी कंट्रीज, जो ब्रिक्स कंट्रीज हैं, वो अपने इंफॉर्मेशन को और अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस को शेयर कर सके. एंड ऑल्सो टू क्रिएट अ नेटवर्किंग ऑफ इनोवेटर्स एंड एंटरप्रेन्योर्स. जो ब्रिक्स कंट्रीज में इनोवेटर्स और एंटरप्रेन्योर्स की एक नेटवर्किंग है, वो बनाई जा सके और उस नेटवर्किंग के थ्रू इंफॉर्मेशन शेयर हो, उस नेटवर्किंग के थ्रू जो एक्सपीरियंस है वो शेयर किया जा सके बिटवीन द कंट्रीज. राइट, एंड द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस एक्शन प्लान वुड बी वर्कड आउट बाय द ब्रिक्स साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी इनोवेशन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप पार्टनरशिप वर्किंग ग्रुप. सो देयर इज अ वर्किंग ग्रुप विद इन द ब्रिक्स व्हिच इज नोन एज व्हाट? ब्रिक्स साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी इनोवेशन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप पार्टनरशिप वर्किंग ग्रुप. सो दिस वर्किंग ग्रुप will look after this plan, will look after the implementation of this plan. All right, so now let's come back to the question. So I hope you can easily answer this. Option A, BRICS is the correct answer. BRICS stands for Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa. I hope you all know this. It is headquartered in Shanghai mein iska headquarter hai. And BRICS has a bank also, which is known as New Development Bank, NDB. NDB is also headquartered in Shanghai. And who is the president of NDB? It's Marcos Prado Troijo from Brazil. All right. And now let's talk about the question number two. That's very, very important question. The Union Cabinet has approved India COVID-19 Emergency Response and Health System Preparedness Package. So this is the phase two of this package. The phase one package was announced in the month of March 2020. जब COVID-19 नया नया आया ही था, when it was introduced in India, at that time India, the government of India announced the phase one of this package to tackle the upcoming COVID situation. And at that time the total outlay was 15,000 crores. The first phase, the total outlay was how much? 15,000 crores. But now the second phase total outlay is how much? 23,123 crores for the year. फॉर द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2021-22, जो ये वाला फाइनेंशियल ईयर है, जो इसमें जो भी 8-9 महीने बचे उसके लिए 23,123 crores has been provided under this second phase. Okay, so let's talk about this. And this package has been announced, guys, to accelerate the health system preparedness. As the name suggests, जो उसके package का नाम है उसमें हमें पता चल रहा है that this is for health preparedness. So this has been announced for acceleration of health system preparedness with the focus on immediate needs for the next 9 months. जो अगले 9-8 महीने बचे हैं इस financial year के, और जो हम सब जानते हैं कि third phase predict की जा चुकी है through the various agencies. उस third phase को tackle करने के लिए, जो COVID का third phase होगा उसको tackle करने के लिए, this phase two of this package has been announced. Remember, it will have two components. One will be the central sector components, another would be centrally sponsored component. So what is the meaning of central sector? I hope you all know this. Central sector means all the funding will be provided by the central government. All the funding will be provided by the central government, while centrally sponsored means the funding, the money, the amount will be shared between the center and states. Center or states mein jab sharing hota hai, then that is known as centrally sponsored. But if the 100% funding is provided by central government, then that is known as central sector. So this second phase will have two components, all right? While the earlier phase one had only one component, that was central sector, which means overall 15,000 crores was provided by central government only in the phase one. But now in the phase two, what will happen is that center will provide rupees 15,000 crores, while the state share would be 8,123 crores, which in total becomes 23,123 crores. 23,123 crores ho jate, okay? Now the duration of this second phase will be from 1st of July 2021 to 31st March 2022 up to the end of this financial year. Jo ye wala financial year hai, jab tak end ho jayega, tab tak ke liye ye hai. Par itna sara paisa ja kahan raha hai? I don't understand. Ye 15,000 crore ye aaye pehle phase 1 mein, fir 20 lakh crore aaye. पता नहीं कितने लाख करोड़ आ गए, कहाँ चले गए, कुछ नहीं समझ आया. फिर ये 23,000 करोड़ और आ गए, कुछ टाइम पहले आरबीआई ने भी दिए थे. पैसा बह रहा है लेकिन वो कहाँ बह रहा है ये समझ नहीं आ रहा. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द सेंट्रल सेक्टर कंपोनेंट. कि सेंट्रल सेक्टर कंपोनेंट में क्या क्या चीजें ये लोग करेंगे. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द स्ट्रेंथनिंग ऑफ नेशनल सेंटर फॉर डिजीज कंट्रोल. नेशनल सेंटर फॉर डिजीज कंट्रोल को स्ट्रेंथन करेंगे. ओके कैसे करेंगे? They will be provided with genome sequencing machine. They will be provided with scientific control room. They will be provided with epidemic intelligence services, and other kind of technical support will also be provided to this board. Okay. So the very first objective behind this phase 2 package is the strengthening of National Center for Disease Control. Then implementation of hospital management information system in all the district hospitals of the country. जितने भी हमारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स हैं उन सब में हॉस्पिटल मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम को इंप्लीमेंट किया जाएगा. एंड करेंटली इट इज इंप्लीमेंटेड ओनली इन 310 डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स. केवल 310 डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल में ये इंप्लीमेंटेड है. बट ड्यूरिंग आफ्टर द इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस फेज टू पैकेज दिस सिस्टम वुड बी इंप्लीमेंटेड इन ऑल द डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स. देन फॉर एक्सपैंडिंग द नेशनल आर्किटेक्चर फॉर of e-Sanjeevani teleconsultation portal. e-Sanjeevani ka naam I hope aap sabne suna hoga. It is basically a teleconsultation portal. So this e-Sanjeevani teleconsultation portal will be expanded, and there is a target that it will provide up to 5 lakh teleconsultations per day, which is currently how much? 50,000. Abhi kitna hai? 50,000 consultation ek din mein jaati hai e-Sanjeevani ke through. The target is to have 5 lakh consultation per day through this portal, which is known as e-Sanjeevani. And then some IT interventions are also there, like strengthening of country's COVID-19 portal, like Arogya Setu app ho gaya, 105 COVID helpline ho gaya, Covin platform ho gaya, jo vaccine ka platform hai. So IT-led interventions bhi kuch kiye jayenge. Now talking about the centrally sponsored component. Centrally sponsored component mein ye jitni bhi cheeze hain, these are not important for the exam. These are just for the basic understanding. At last, what they are doing, okay? ये सारी चीजें याद रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. दीज आर वेरी जेनरिक थिंग्स एंड ये एग्जाम में नहीं पूछी जाएंगी, डोंट वरी. क्रिएशन ऑफ पीडियाट्रिक यूनिट्स इन ऑल द 736 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, देन ऑगमेंटिंग 20,000 आईसीयू बेड्स इन पब्लिक हेल्थ केयर सिस्टम्स, आउट ऑफ व्हिच 20% विल बी पीडियाट्रिक, बिकॉज ऐसा प्रेडिक्ट किया गया था दैट द थर्ड फेज विल इंपैक्ट चिल्ड्रन मोर. देन क्रिएटिंग प्री फैब्रिकेटेड स्ट्रक्चर्स फॉर एडिंग एडिशनल बेड्स एट द एग्जिस्टिंग हेल्थ सेंटर्स. Installation of 1050 numbers of liquid medical oxygen storage plants. Then augmenting the existing fleet of ambulances, 8800 ambulances will be added under this second phase. Then engagement of undergraduate and postgraduate medical interns so that they can also contribute during the shortage of doctors. Abhi humne second phase mein dekha tha ki there was an acute shortage of doctors, there was an acute shortage of medical professionals. So us cheez ko tackle karne ke liye they will be providing. They will be provided with the internships or the basic training. Then support is provided to the states to maintain at least 20.5 lakhs COVID tests per day. States ko strengthen kiya jayega, states ko assistance di jayegi ki 21.5 lakh test COVID ke ek din mein kam se kam hone chahiye. Okay. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. Question was, it is a dash. Okay, so it is a central sector scheme, and it is also a centrally sponsored scheme, which means option E, both A and B. Now remember this, the phase two package has both the components of central sector and centrally sponsored. While in the phase one, there was only one component, that was central sector, which means the phase one was completely funded by the central government. But now there is some share of the state governments also. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is again a very important question, especially for NABARD. ये NABARD के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा important है और NABARD का exam अब कभी भी आ सकता है, तो अपनी preparations को चालू रखो. With regards to the modification approved in the Agriculture Infrastructure Fund by the Union Cabinet, mark the correct set out of the given options. If you remember that this Agriculture Infrastructure Fund was announced in the month of May 2020, जब 20 लाख करोड़ का एक huge package government ने launch किया था, and the total corpus of this fund was how much? 1 lakh crores. So to extend this corpus, to extend this funding, to extend this Agriculture Infrastructure Fund, some new guidelines have been provided by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. Now this modifications has been done to achieve a multiplier effect in generating investment. So basically, जो agriculture sector है, वहाँ पे investment को बढ़ावा देने के लिए, to boost the investment in the agriculture sector, these modifications have been done under this fund. Now who are eligible? Now इसमें पहली बात तो होता क्या है, पहले मैं पहले बता देता हूँ एग्रीकल्चर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फंड में होता क्या है. सो इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन, बेसिकली इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन ऑफ अप टू 3% इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑन अ लोन अप टू ₹2 crores. और ये लोन क्यों दिया जाता है? फॉर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बिल्डिंग. ऑलराइट, ये किसके लिए दिया जाता है? इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बिल्डिंग. सो बेसिकली इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बिल्डिंग के लिए एग्रीकल्चर में जो लोन दिए जाएंगे अप टू ₹2 crores, उसमें गवर्नमेंट विल प्रोवाइड इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन ऑफ 3%. दैट वॉज द यूज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फंड. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द मॉडिफिकेशन. सो एलिजिबिलिटी हैज नाउ बीन एक्सटेंडेड टू स्टेट एजेंसीज और द APMCs, नेशनल एंड स्टेट फेडरेशंस ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव्स, फेडरेशंस ऑफ FPOs, फार्मर प्रोड्यूसर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड फेडरेशन ऑफ सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स. सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स पहले इन्वॉल्व इसमें इंक्लूडेड नहीं थे. देन द लोन लिमिट, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द लोन लिमिट, सो लोन लिमिट तो अभी भी इतनी है 2 crore rupees, बट देर इज वन चेंज. एंड वॉट इज दैट चेंज? सो इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन फॉर अ लोन अप टू ₹2 crores विल ऑल्सो बी प्रोवाइडेड इफ वन एलिजिबल एंटिटी पुट्स अ प्रोजेक्ट इन डिफरेंट लोकेशन. अगर एक एंटिटी अलग अलग लोकेशन में भी अपने प्रोजेक्ट लगाएगी, देन दैट एंटिटी विल ऑल्सो गेट द इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन अंडर दिस स्कीम. अर्लियर अकॉर्डिंग टू द अर्लियर प्रोविजन, जो पुराने प्रोविजन थे उसके हिसाब से ये था कि जो एक एलिजिबल एंटिटी है दैट कैन पुट प्रोजेक्ट ओनली वन लोकेशन. सो द इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन वॉज प्रोवाइडेड फॉर ओनली वन लोकेशन. बट नाउ इफ एनी वन एलिजिबल एंटिटी इज पुटिंग अप इट्स प्रोजेक्ट इन डिफरेंट लोकेशन, देन ऑल्सो द इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एंड अप टू ₹2 crores. ओके, अमाउंट में कोई चेंज नहीं आया. Now talking about the duration, so it has been extended from 10 years to 13 years. Earlier the duration was up to 10 years, but now it has been extended up to 13 years up to 2032-33, which means the financial year 2033 tak iski duration hai. And also the repayment period has also been extended from the existing 4 years to 6 years up to 2025-26. Okay, jo repayment period hai usko bhi badha ke kitna kar diya gaya, 4 saal se 6 saal. So these are some of the modifications, and now let's come back to the question. So you have to find the correct set out of the given options. All right, so extensions up to 2032-33, this is correct. Extension in the number of locations for interest subvention, yes, earlier the interest subvention was given for only one location, but now if any one eligible entity puts up its project in different location, then also he will get the interest subvention. Extension in the repayment period from 4 to 6 years. So all the statements are correct, which means option D. All are correct, guys, would be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to the last question for today, question number 4. Where has India's first LNG facility plan been inaugurated? Ye koi bahut zyada important question nahi hai, but looking at the pattern of the RBI exam, we can expect this question also in 1 marks. So India's first LNG facility plant has been inaugurated at Nagpur, which is of course in Maharashtra. And Nagpur is the Lok Sabha constituency of, we all know, Nitin Gadkari, the city of oranges, Nagpur. And Nitin Gadkari is the Minister of Road Transport and Highways. Earlier, he was also the Minister of MSMEs. So Nagpur here is the correct answer. That's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.